All right, appraisers, this is Brandon with Choice Valuation. And in this Spark Spotlight video, I'm going to be covering how to understand and configure your MC profiles. Now, there's another video we have covering the profiles when you're on the 1004 MC side. And this video is specifically for when you're on the trend dashboard side. The profiles are the same. So your My Standard profile, it'll load in data the way you want for that profile on here. And it also saves your settings over on the Trent dashboard side as well. Okay, so what exactly does it mean to have a profile? A profile is the setup of how you're analyzing data for each of these feature sets, like sale price, housing supply, days on market. It's exactly how you like to analyze your market. So when I click to view or edit my analyses, then it's this. So it saves everything about like what kind of chart you have, how far back it's going, what exactly you're analyzing, whether it's median price, price per square foot, how you're building the comments, all that stuff. It's all part of your profile. When you make a change, like what I did is I just went in and I added this chart, and I'll make another one. So now I just added another chart. When I hit save layout, it saves this layout to this profile that shows up right here. So this is my standard profile. And I don't actually want those or those. So that's how I want to save it. So I'm going to hit save layout. And now that saves that. So next time I go to use Spark, as long as I'm in the My Standard profile, then it will load things in just how I want for that. And that applies to all of these feature sets. And it also applies to what feature sets are being analyzed. So for example, if I go in here and I say, you know what, I want to add the price ratio feature set. It adds it down here at the bottom, and now that is saved into my standard profile. So next time I load up that, it's going to automatically know that I want price ratio down here. And if I move it right up to here, now that goes and it saves that again to the My Standard profile. So when I load up Spark again, as long as I'm in My Standard, then it will load in price ratio right here, third from the bottom. All right, so that's the way it works. It saves all of your analyses, your comments, your setup exactly how you want it. And you can go in here and I can click that and I can switch to other profiles. So right here you see it says your profiles. So these are my four profiles right here, and I have the My Standard set as the default as well. So this is the one it always loads into. I have a standard, a neighborhood, and a historic. Now in Spark, we have a library of profiles. So I can go in here and say, hey, you know what? I wanna see what the Spark alternate profile is. So I can click that. And what it does is it copies that alternate profile from the Spark library right into your profile. So now when I click in here, it copied that alternate profile right into mine. So I can click that, it loads it in, and now I'm using that profile. And so if I go in here, I can say view edit analyses. And what it's doing is it's analyzing my competing data and my alternative set of data, but I haven't uploaded that yet. And so that's what it does by default. Then one more thing I want to show you is that I can click here and I can manage my profiles. And so I can go in here and I can say, okay, I want to rename this alternate one to just say alternate, or you can name it, you know, whatever you want. I can change the color scheme. And what that means is when you're loading in, let's just do it for neighborhood. When you're loading in the color scheme right here, it says your first card in a widget will be blue. The second card will always be red, but I can, whoops, didn't mean to do that, but I can go in and change it. So I can click on this red one and say, you know what? I want that to be purple. And so now it's going to show up as purple. And I will show you in a minute what I mean by that. Clone, so I can make an exact copy of this and have it show up here, and I can rename it to second neighborhood, and it shows up right there. I can also remove it, so I'll do that now. I don't want that. And I can also set any one of these as my default, and that's pretty much it. And I can also add a profile from scratch and just build it completely from scratch. All right, so now let me just show you. I'm going to switch over to that neighborhood profile, and now you can see what the charts are going to look like using the neighborhood profile, because you saw that I switched that from, I believe it was from red to purple. And so now that's what it looks like. Pretty hideous in my opinion, but you can do whatever you want there as far as colors go. Okay, that's it. Thanks for watching.